Hey guys, it's Kenan the Scientist, and happy holidays! Christmas is coming up in 3 days, and I'm so excited! Anywho, today we are going to be reading another National Geographic book. I noticed that you guys really liked these ones, so we are going to be doing another one. This one is called Storms, and it is by Miriam Bush Goyne. So let's start the book, okay? First chapter is Weather. Storms are important. Living things need fresh water from rain and snow. Wind can help clean the air. Weather cools and heats our planet, so it is just right for life.
Here's the picture.
Clouds are made of drops of water, so small they float. These clouds look heavy and gray. Can you hear the wind blow? Leaves wave back and forth on branches. What's happening? Wild, wonderful, stormy weather. Next chapter is Thunder and Lightning. Flash! Boom! In these storm clouds, the drops of water have frozen. Little ice crystals are bumping wildly against big crystals. This makes lightning. Lightning heats the air quickly. This is very fast temperature change, makes sound waves. This sound is called thunder. Lightning is electricity. It is hotter than the sun. Some lightning jumps from cloud to cloud. Some jumps from the ground to the sky. Lightning can make loops and patterns in the sky. It can even roll in a ball. Lightning bolts can travel 60 miles or more. That is a lot. Hailstorm. Thunk, clunk. Some thunderstorms make hailstones. Hailstones are not stones, they are ice. Ice crystals in some thunderclouds get tumbled in the cloud. They get bigger and bigger until they are so heavy they fall. Hail can be big or small. It can be round or long. So this is a picture of an unusually big hailstone right here. So as you can see, it's just a big clump of ice. Okay, tornado. Strong winds blow. Dark clouds cover the sky. Hail falls. Suddenly, it is quiet. In the distance, a cone-shaped funnel cloud touches the ground. Tornado, twister, cyclone. These are all names for a fierce, twisting wind. Over water, tornadoes are called water sprouts. So here's the picture of the funnel tornado. Sandstorm. A wall of wind picks up sand. As the wind crosses the land, it picks up more and more sand. The wall grows higher. When it roars past, it can knock down fences. In Australia, they call the storms willy willies. In Sudan, they call them haboobs. Blizzard. Snowflakes fall from very cold clouds. A cold wind blows the snow so hard you cannot see in front of you. Snowflakes are ice crystals. In a blizzard, there are billions and trillions of snowflakes. That is a lot. Monsoon. Monsoons are winds that change each season. India has only two seasons. Winter monsoons are dry. Summer monsoons bring lots of rain. Everyone cheers because the rain helps the food grow. Hurricane. It is late summer. Dark clouds form over the ocean. Strong winds pull ocean water up into spinning clouds. Hurricane, cyclone, typhoon. Hurricane winds knock down houses. The water floods streets and homes. Hurricane winds spin in a circle. The middle of a hurricane is still and calm. It is called the eye of the storm.
Here's the picture.
Out of this world. Where are the worst storms? Not on Earth. Jupiter's hurricane has been blowing for more than 400 years. In 2006, a lightning storm on Saturn lasted for 2 weeks. The lightning bolts were more than 1,000 times stronger than Earth's. Neptune has winds that blow 900 miles per hour.
Here's the picture.
Guess. Storms are made of many small parts. Together with wind, these tiny bits are strong. Guess which each bit is.
So, this is little sand pebbles. This is a snowflake. This is like water on a leaf. And then I think this is like giant ice cubes.
Okay. House for a storm. This home is on stilts. After monsoon, the water and mud flow under the house. In a sandstorm, this tent keeps the sand out. An underground storm cellar keeps people safe during a tornado.
So here are all the houses that you can be safe during a storm.
Wild animals, wild weather. In a blizzard, winds these muxon huddle together. They face the wind so their bodies stay warmer. In a habub, camels shut a second pair of eyelids to protect their eyes from sand. Their long, thin nostrils and extra hairy ears keep sand out. In a monsoon, rains, some monkeys keep dry in buildings or under branches. Other monkeys don't mind getting wet. And that is the end of the book. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And I hope you enjoyed. See you guys next time. Bye!